Number two, I've got content repurposing, right? You have a very small team, but you have a big footprint out there of the content you produce and you push out.
Yeah. So every week, you know, for some reason, when we were talking about this earlier, I felt like I didn't do that much in this area, but you kind of convinced me that I did. So we'll talk about it now. So every single week I put out one blog post, one podcast episode, one YouTube video, and then I have actually Instagram and Twitter now on autopilot, and I'm going to be starting a TikTok channel in a couple of weeks. Now, on the surface, that actually sounds like a lot, but I actually do a lot of content repurposing, and for me, it always just starts out with the blog. Every single week on Sunday morning while my kids are in Russian math for 4 hours, just thought I'd put that in there, I sit down and I write literally for 4 hours straight, and I put out that one 3,000 to 5,000 word blog post. And from that blog post, sometimes for my YouTube video, all I do is just take the exact words sometimes, because I write like how I talk. Sometimes I take those exact words and just put out a YouTube video. Other times I'll just take bullet points from that, just turn on the camera and just riff on it. And for YouTube especially, I think it's important that you have a setup in your office where all you got to do is click one button and start recording. Like the lights have to be set up and everything. If you don't have that, forget about it. It's not going to happen. So what I do then after that, so I have this blog post. And for the podcast, that's not really automated, because the purpose of the podcast for me is just to get to know people. Mm-hmm. So I'll just have someone like my assistant schedule out interviews in advance, which require no prep on my part for the most part, because I just riff based on the answers that they give, kind of like how we're doing it right now. For Twitter and social media, I actually hired recently a consultant that just consumes all of my content, YouTube, podcasts, everything, and puts together these little, you know, tweets that go out 3 times a day. And then I take those and I put those on Instagram, and those are actually going to be the fundamentals of my TikTok channel as well.
Wait, do you post the tweets, like pictures of the tweets on Instagram, or do you do something different on Instagram?
So the tweets are actually in this Google Sheet, which ones are going out. And I kind of see how they perform on Twitter, and I pick the best ones. And then I, this part's manual. I'll find like a family picture or some picture to go along with it for Instagram.
Cool. How long have you been taking dance lessons to prepare for your TikTok entry?
You know, I just finished. I finished a 3-month series on hip hop dancing, which is going to be the fundamentals of my TikTok channel. You know, what's funny about this is I told Austin this and you actually believed me.
I did. Before we went on, he was talking about TikTok and I was like, that's impressive. Steve's committed to his craft. Okay. So very interesting. So you're repurposing everything here, and you've got now from one blog post, that one blog post turns into Instagram, tweets, a YouTube video, and also an email. Does the email go out as well?
Email goes out, but that part's not automated. But yes, I email out all these pieces of content to my audience on a weekly basis.
Cool. And does that come from the writing, or is that a separate email that you're writing?
Usually it depends how much time I have. Like if I don't have that much time, sometimes I'll just cut and paste like an excerpt from the blog post as an intro for the video. But you got to understand, like, all these pieces of content aren't going out at the same time.
Yes.
Right. So I stagger them. So like the YouTube video of that blog post might come out like months later.
Okay,
so it doesn't feel like it's all going out at the same time.
And how do you manage that? Do you have any tools that you use to manage that? Or is that all Google Sheets?
It's all just Google Sheets. I mean, that part is kind of manual, and there's no real method. I just wait and see if it's been long enough, basically, that I publish the other post.
Cool. That's awesome. And so you're doing all of this. Do you have anyone helping you push publish, or is it just you?
So the Twitter stuff is all automated.
Okay.
Instagram, that's all kind of curated by me, because I feel like my Instagram is a little bit more personal, and I use a tool called Planoly to just schedule everything out. So I'm scheduled out for like 3 months already for that.
Oh, awesome.
So I don't have to touch that. Podcast, my VA handles that. My VA actually edits all my videos also. She actually edits all my TikToks as well. So that,
cool.
Yeah, she's been amazing.
Steve, I can tell already you're going to have a massive TikTok following.
Dude, I'm excited. I just actually interviewed a TikTok consultant this morning on my podcast. And
cool.
So she gave me all these pointers. I think in terms of just expanding your reach, it seems like TikTok is probably the best platform right now, or the fastest growing one for sure.